Listen, tell me about you being in the UK and going to London. You were very young. I think you were 17. Is that right, Jessie? And you got there. I just had this image of 17 with a suitcase and a dream, which sounds like a country song.
Yeah, and you should write it.
You should get that down. And there you go. And, you know, you work your way around the place. But it's the benefactor I was intrigued by, this knight in shining armour. Who's this guy? What did he do?
When I first moved over, I was completely boundaryless. I just was kind of so hungry and excited to be part of something that I thought would take at least 10 decades to kind of be part of.
Of course.
And so I had no kind of, I didn't understand what, like, you need to survive. So I was on 300 a week, which you can't really, you can't even get the tube on that over in London. And anyway, this amazing man, he basically came to see me in a little night music, and he got in touch, and he has nothing to do with the industry. And
yes.
He said, look, I think he'd been in the Sound of Music when he was really young, and he just had a love for theatre.
Right.
And his name's Tony Bernstein.
And why is he so important to you?
Because I wouldn't be here without him. And he, he paid for, my training, he paid for my rent, he paid for food shopping when I couldn't, you know. And pure, the kindness of strangers is incredible, and I'm incredibly lucky to have met amazing people like him in my life.
And he wanted to help a talented person and just say, look, they deserve a go. I didn't have it. I didn't go that road, but I can afford to help her.
Yeah.
It's pretty out there.
He's an angel. He's pretty special.
I can see that. I can see that he obviously means a lot to you as well. What I'm also glad to say is that when you were singing there, I just caught a quick cheeky glance up to your mum and dad, who were sitting there looking at you. And they are the proudest people in Ireland when you're performing. I can say that to you easy enough. But they must have featured largely in your success too. And you know.
Oh God, why are you bloody trying to make me cry now?
No.
I'm the one who's making people cry.
No. This is revenge. Then this is karma. No, but I'm not really. I'm just saying that. I'm just there here. Wouldn't you allow me to talk about them?
They're the most incredible people. Together, separately, as parents, as inspirations, they've always given us the gift that life is to be experienced, and there's nothing that you can't do, and that every single one of us has a voice that is, you know, important in the world. And I owe all the value systems that I've learned to them. So,
well, thanks. That's lovely. That's nice. And they're lovely people.